bakalım. Daha şurası marım ham şun daha çok unutmamız mı daha çar yıntamın de grup yıntaram şurada ismi tekrar nana malim karunalim namami bhagavat padam şankaram lok şankaram şankaram şankaracaryam keşavam badrayanam sutra bhashyam tu vande bhagavantau punah punah ishvaro guru ratmeti murti bhed vibhagine yomavat vyapta dehaya dakshinamurtaye namah सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणो विदाति पुरोहिताग्निश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तवो महदेवात्मबुद्धिः प्रकाशमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्री चिद्घनगणेशाय नमो वयं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मलमपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहन्नमत्वान्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः सिक्स्थ चैप्टर तर्कदृष्टिस क्वेश्चन्स आर बीइंग आंसर्ड through a dream example of Agrada Deva, where he is the Shishya and the Guru is answering the questions, all the questions, by showing how Sankhya's analysis is invalidated. Now Tarkika Mata is being taken. Last we saw that Tasmat Sankhya Bhi Mata Atma Bhedaha Nayuktaha. Atma Bheda is not valid. And the Tippanakara showed as to there are lot of Tarkagata doshas also in the Sankhya Mata. Trivida Nayayika Matavarnanam Tan Nirakarananja Atma Vyapakaiti Matavarnanam Tatkhandananja Atmanaha Vyapakattu Upapadanam. So all these three topics are covered here in various set of avartas. So the Nayayikas of three types, they are refuted. Atma Vyapaka. Desi Atma is Vyapaka, but there is Atma Atma Bheda. So Atma Atma Bheda and Vyapaka won't work. We saw the same issue in the Sankhya Mata also. And what is this Vyapakatva of Atma that is discussed here? Jivasya Anekatva Vyapakatva Nityatva Jnana Gunakatvadi Varnanam. So Jiva being many, as well as Vyapaka Atma, then being Nitya, Nitya, Vyapaka and many. Then having Jnana and Guna. Jnana Guna. So Jnana Guna Kattvam Jivasya. Jiva having Jnana and as its Guna. All these are discussed here. Sankhyanam eva Nayayikanam api Atma Bhedaha Asangata eva. So Nayayika Mata also where Atma Atma Bheda is considered, that is not valid. Esha cha Nayayika Siddhanta. What do they talk about in their Siddhanta? Sukham, Dukham, Jnanam, Ichha, Dvesha, Prayatna, Dharma, Adharma, Jnana Janya, Samskaraha, Sankhya, Parimanam, Pruthaktam, Sanyoga, Vibhagaha, Iti, Chaturdasha, Gunaha, Jiva Rupa, Atma Nishthaha. Jiva is Atma, Swarupataha, but that Atma Nishtha Gunas are there. There are 14 gunas which are there in the Atma. So those are listed. We are not really worried about what all these gunas are. But Sukha Dukha we know, Jnana, Ichha, Dvesha, Prayatna, Dharma, Adharma, all these we know, Jnana Janya Samskar also we know. But these are all Antakkarana Gata for Vedantin, because Shruti also discusses that, and it is very clear, Drishyatvat. It cannot be your own guna because it is Drishya. Then Sankhya, Parimana, Pratakto, Sanyoga, Vibhaga, all these are also gunas of atma, which are in the atma. This is what Nayayika says. Nayayikas, Nyaya Vaisheshikas are put together generally. There is a difference between how many gunas and all that. Vaisheshika Matha is comparatively, if you compare Vaisheshika and Nayayikas, Vaisheshika is slightly simpler in fact. Sankhya Parimanam Pratakthum Sanyoga Vibhaga Jnanam Ichha Prayatna Iti Ashtav Guna Ishwara Nishtaha. So Jeeva and Ishwara Bheda is there. Jeeva has 14 gunas, whereas 8 gunas are there in Ishwara. So Ishwara also has gunas. Tatra Etavan Bheda Asti. What is the difference between Jeeva and Ishwara's gunas there? Ishwarasya Jnana Ichha Prayatnaha Nityaha. Jiva also has jnana, ichha and prayatna, but Jiva's jnana, ichha and prayatnas are not nitya. Whereas Ishvara's jnana, ichha shakti, jnana shakti and kriya shakti which is there, which is involved in prayatna. All these are nitya. Jivasya jnana aditrayam anityam. So this is how you make a difference between this alpa jiva and Ishwara, who is Sarvajna Sarvashaktiman. This is how we talk about it. They make a difference by saying that Jnana Ichha Prayatna are there in both. They are Atma Nishta Guna, but difference is that in Vyashti it is Anitya and Samashti it is Nitya. Ishwara Ekaha Vyapakaha Nityascha. Ishwara is Ekaha Vyapakaha Nityaha Jeevaha Tu. Nitya and Vyapaka, all right, but not Ekaha. Jeevastu Nana Sarvatra Vyapaka Nityascha. So Ishwara is Vyapaka, Jeeva is also Vyapaka. Ishwara is Nitya, Jeeva is also Nitya. Why? Atmatvat. But Jeeva is Aneka Nana, whereas Ishwara is Ekaha. Jeevasya Jnanam Anityam. Tasmad yada jnana rupa gunaha asti tada chetanaha yada jnana gunaha nashtaha tada jadaha pashana tulyo bhavati. So jiva, who is discussed as atma, how is he not going to be having nitya jnana? So this jnana makes the jiva chetana, but that jnana being anitya, as long as Jiva has Jnana, he is Chetana. When that Jnana Guna comes in, he becomes Chetana. Otherwise, he is Jada. So this is how they have ended up concluding. Just like the French philosopher, René Descartes said that, I think therefore I am. So that thinking is Jnana Guna. Nayayika has said it long back. I am Chetana. So he talked about Chetana, that Chetana makes a person think that I am Sat. So derivative is the French philosopher's conclusion. It's a derivative if you look at it. I think, I am conscious, therefore I exist. This is how they have concluded. Nayayika has already been saying that. Jnana Gunaha. So jnana rupa guna yada asti tada chetana jiva. Yada jnana guna nashta bhavati tada jiva achetana bhavati pashana tulya. He is comparable to a stone. Jiveshwara viva akasha kala ding manamsi api nityani. Now this jiva, atma, is a padartha. First they start by talking about padarthas. So akasha kala dik manamsi api nitya. They are also nitya. Prithvi jalatejo vayu nam paramanavaha nityaha gavaksha jalak nirgateshu surya kiraneshu upalabhyamana sukshma rajasa shashto bhagaha paramanuriti kirtyate sa paramanuhu atmavat nityaha. Now they come to their darshana. What do they talk about it? They say that the entire prapancha is made of padarthas. Atma is a padartha, there are others also. Now you have to look at the others, understand the others, understand yourself also, that jnana will make you free. What kind of jnana? यू आर बीइंग एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज एवरीथिंग द वे इट इज. सो यू लुक एट द पदार्थास, यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट दे आर. देर इज भय, देर इज संसार एंड दुख, बिकॉज ऑल दीज पदार्थास अराउंड यू आर कॉजिंग दुख. दिस मच यू मे एग्री. Now, if you agree about them, what does he say is that the reason you have dukkha is because you don't understand the others. You don't understand yourself as well. So, the way Vedantin talks about mix-up, he also says that there you are confused. However, you do not know the reality of each and every tattva. You have to know the other things also. You have to know your bheda from the others. So Viveka that we talk about, they also talk about in a different way. We say that once you have negated everything by a little analysis also, you land on your real Atma, you hold on to that. They say you just keep on discussing and endlessly analyzing everything. Once you have no other question left to analyze, any other Padartha left to analyze, you know everything, then you are free. How is this prapancha created? All these padarthas, they have come from paramanus. These paramanus, the atoms are what? They are prithvi jala tejo vayunam paramanavaha nityaha. These atoms at various levels, across padarthas, if you start analyzing the paramanus, prithvi jala and teja, prithvi jala teja and vayu, akasha, they consider as nitya ekaha. Vibhu, but this prithivi, jala, tejas and vayu, their paramanus are nitya. They have atoms which are nitya. What is this paramanu now, atom? Shashtaha bhaga paramanu riti kirtyate. The sixth part of what? Gavaksha jalaka nirgateshu surya kiraneshu upalabhyamana sukshma rajasaha shashtaha bhaga. So sixth part of a particle. What particle which can be seen with the naked eye when you are sleeping at night in a house with the windows shut, curtains are drawn, but then maybe a village house also, when you open the curtains and there is a window, is not a glass window, it is a wooden window or a door. So when you have the ray of light coming in from some gap in the window or something like that, when the ray, you see in a dark room the ray of light coming in, there in that ray of light you see some dust particles. So the dust particle that you can see with the naked eye in that kind of a light, sixth part of that is paramanu. Some analysis is there as to describing the size of that paramanu. So that is basically saying that whatever smallest amsha you can see with your naked eye, it is 1/6 of that. So it is not the atom of a scientist, it is their own description of atom. The scientist atom was discovered later, but here, so that model is later, but this paramanu, what we say as it is atom, it is a different atom, but it is 1/6 of that is the size. Basically you cannot see with your eyes. जात्यादयः अन्यपि केचन पदार्थः न्यायमते नित्यः सन्ति. However, these paramanus are nitya. The prithvi, jala, teja and vayu, these are the first padarthas created, panchamahabhutas, their paramanus are nitya. And sa paramanu, that nitya how? Atmavat nitya. Atma is nitya, paramanu is also nitya like atma. Therefore, there is at the most fundamental level, there is Bheda. Jatyadayanyapi kechana padartha nyayamate nityaha santi. So jati. Jati is something that rests in a padartha. Now if you look at it, species. One species is differentiated from the other. You group all these in one species and then differentiate this group from the other group of whatever it is, through a jati. So that jati is also nitya. If a member of a species goes away, the species still continues in another member and yet other member. So this species, this jati, which is there in one member of the species, is there in the other member of the species also. That continues that because it is nitya. So jatyadayah anya api kechana padartha nyayamate nityaha santi. वेद विरुद्ध सिद्धांतानां बहुनाम लेखने जिज्ञासूनां प्रयोजनं नास्ति इति नात्र ते लिख्यन्ते. सो इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड लुक एट देयर दर्शन, इट इज ऑल नॉट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग बिकॉज वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन दी आत्मतत्व एंड दी भेद हाउ दे एस्टैब्लिश. वी आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन देयर कैटेगराइजेशन एंड व्हाट दे टॉक अबाउट, व्हाट इज नित्य, व्हाट इज अनित्य, एंड व्हाट रेस्ट्स इन व्हाट, etc. All that can never be proven. It will have Shruti Virodha also. When you talk about all these jatyade anyapi kechana padarthaha nyayamate nityaha santi, then how many nityaha is a plural in their mata? Whereas Shruti talks about as nitya, what can be nitya? Only Brahmatma can be nitya. There is none other which can have nityatvam. Can be talked to have nityatvam. Veda viruddha siddhantanam bahunam lekhane jidnyasunam prayojanam nasti. Jidnyasu, we are interested in jnana about atma. All this is not interesting. Therefore, being Veda viruddha also, jidnyasu is not interested. So, he is not going to talk about it in detail. Aham manushya brahmana iti dehe atma bhrantir bhavati. This is what we are interested in. What do you talk about atma? So, nayayika say that अहम मनुष्यः ब्राह्मणः. फ्रॉम जाति इज लैंडेड इनटू सम स्पीशीज. मनुष्यत्व इज अ जाति. इन दैट आल्सो यू हैव कैटेगराइजेशन ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्य शूद्र. पुरुषः स्त्री, ऑल दीज जातीज आर क्रिएटेड अमोंग जातीज. अमोंग देम देयर इज जाति एंड सो ऑन. सो अहम मनुष्य ब्राह्मण ऑल दिस जाति. मनुष्यत्व इटसेल्फ इज अ भ्रांति. इन दैट ब्राह्मणत्व इज अ भ्रांति. इन दैट पुंस्त्व और स्त्रीत्व इज अ भ्रांति. इति देहे आत्म भ्रांतिर भवति बिकॉज ऑल दोज आर गुणास ऑफ द देह. इट्स अ जाति ऑफ द देह. आत्म भ्रांतिर भवति. नाउ वी आर इंटरेस्टेड. ओके, आत्म भ्रांतिर भवति. आत्मत्व इज there in the, there is a tadatmya sambandha there. This is what we call as tadatmya sambandha. Tataha ragadvesha ubhavata. So now we are excited that we are coming to some concrete discussion. Not, you know, beating around about discussing everything except for atma tattva. So ragadvesha is there for a person because there is deha sambandha. भ्रांति भ्रांति संबंध ताभ्याम धर्माधर्म निमित्ते कर्मणि प्रवृत्तिर भवति. सो दिस इज इन लाइन विद शास्त्र. विद दी शरीर संबंध द राग द्वेष विच इज देयर इन द सूक्ष्म शरीर. दिस इज व्हाट द फैक्ट इज. हाउ डू दे टॉक अबाउट इट. आत्म भ्रांतिर भवति तथा राग द्वेषो भवतः. वेयर आत्मनि. The problem is atmani bhavataha. Tabhyam dharma dharma nimitte karmani pravrittir bhavati. To meet the raga, to get away from dvesha, one does dharma adharma. This dharma adharma have created raga dvesha, and through raga dvesha, one does karma, which lead to dharma adharma again. And the cycle continues. So karmani pravrittir bhavati, driven by raga dvesha, for which karma, the dharma and adharma, is the nimitta. Tataha sharira sambandha dvara sukha dukkhadayaha bhavanti. So where is the sukha dukkha? Atmani. How? Sharira sambandha dvara. इत्थम न्यायमते आत्मन संसारम प्रति भ्रांति ज्ञानमेव कारणम. नाउ वी आर लुकिंग एट समन्वय. आत्म भ्रांति भवति खलु. देन आत्मभ्रांति वाइज भ्रांति देर इन एनी केस वेर इज दी भ्रांति रज्जु सर्प भ्रांति शुक्ति रजत भ्रांति. सो वेन यू हैव भ्रांति वॉट इज ड्यू टू वॉट इज इट ड्यू टू इट इज ड्यू टू अज्ञान. सो भ्रांति ज्ञानम एव कारणम संसारम प्रति. नाउ दिस भ्रांति ज्ञान अज्ञान कृत भ्रांति ज्ञान इज दी कारण फॉर संसार ऑफ आत्मा. दिस इज वॉट न्यायमता इज. तच्च भ्रांति ज्ञानम तत्व ज्ञानात् निवर्तते. इट ऑल्सो गोज फ्रॉम तत्व ज्ञान. नाउ वॉट तत्व ज्ञान. तत्व ज्ञान इन दी वेदांत केस इट इज आत्मज्ञान. देह से देहादि सकल पदार्थेभ्य आत्मा भिन्न इति निश्चयैव तत्वज्ञानम्. व्हाट इज तत्वज्ञान. नोइंग योरसेल्फ निश्चयेन विदाउट एनी डाउट दैट आई एम भिन्न आई एम डिफरेंट आई एम आत्मा हु इज भिन्न डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट देहादि सकल पदार्थास फ्रॉम ऑल दी पदार्थास इंक्लूडिंग देह. सो भिन्न अत्र अयम विशेष. व्हाट इज दिस भिन्नत्व बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट देयर. नैयायिक मते तत्वज्ञानस्य हेतुर मननम. दिस निश्चय विच यू हैव टू हैव अबाउट योर बीइंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दी देहादि पदार्थास व्हाट इज दी कारण फॉर दैट. फॉर अ वेदांती इट इज श्रुति. फॉर अ Nayayika Manana. Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, they also talk about. Because Shruti says it. So Shravana, all right. Manana Siddha. Is it Manana Siddha? That will make or break the Tattva Jnana. So this Tattva Jnana Sikhetuhu Mananam Nayayika Mati. This Manana, they give a lot of importance to. And then primarily they set aside Shravana also. They are not really interested in so much of Shravana. Shravana, Manana, Nidhyasana need not have any sequence also. They say Manana is important. Atma itara padarthebhya bhinnaha. This is the Manana. I am different from the Dehadi Padarthas. Why? Atmatvat. Hetu is also there. Atmatvat. Atma. That itself is a Hetu. Why? Because everything else is anatma. So atmatva itara padarthebhya anatmabhya bhinnaha. Yaha itara padarthebhya bhinnaha na bhavati kintu itara padartha rupayo bhavati sa na atma. Look at this manana. How convoluted it is. That which is not different from other padarthas, but is in the same form as the other padarthas, that is not atma. Atma is always different from the other padarthas. Yatha ghataha. Now they take the example of ghataha. What is ghataha? So this is what we talk about as reflexive pronoun. When you look at anything, the self, who is the self? That which is different from the other padarthas is self. I am one who is different from everything else. So if you look at from the perspective of the ghata, you look at the ghata, yatha ghataha, iti vyatirekya anumanena atmani itara padartha bhedanumiti jnanam bhavati. So anumiti jnanam. From anumana, there is an anumiti jnana. Anumiti is a jnana which takes place from anumana as a pramana. This ghataha is a vyatireka drishtanta. Is ghata you? No, I am not the ghata. Why? Ghata is different from me. I am different from the ghata. So, that which is yaha itara padarthebhya bhinnaha na bhavati. This ghata is not different from other things. Other ghatas. I mean, it is a ghatatva as a jati if you look at it. Yaha itara padarthebhya bhinna na bhavati kintu itara padartha rupayo bhavati sana atma. Very strange kind of expressions are there if you look at it. So you have to go deeper and understand where they are coming from. But you are different from the others. You look from your perspective. You look at everything else. घटा इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अनदर घटा, ओके, बट इट हैज सिमिलर फॉर्म ऑफ द अदर घटा, दैट इज नॉट आत्मा, दैट इज अनात्मा इति व्यतिरेक अनुमानेन आत्मनि इतर पदार्थ भेदानुम इति ज्ञानम भवति. सो यू लुक कीप ऑन लुकिंग एट इट, आई एम नॉट दिस, आई एम नॉट दिस, यू नो आई एम नॉट दिस टेबल, आई एम नॉट दिस. When you keep on analyzing it, then you know that you are not any of these padarthas. They are all anatma. I, who am I? I am this atma who is different from these other padarthas. Other padarthas. Other padarthas are known. How that logic falls apart, we'll see in a moment. But, idam eva jnanam mananam iti kachyate. This is manana. So you keep on thinking, you look at other things. Is it different from you? Are you different from all that? Then, with this differentiation, you know that everything else is anatma, you are atma. Ida itara padartha jnanamantara atmani itara padartha bheda jnanam na sambhavet. So, the bheda that they talk about, they are saying that I have bheda from the, in atma there is bheda. Bheda from the other padarthas. This is resting in the Atma. So this is what you are actually analyzing. In that manana, you are analyzing that I am different from the other padarthas. That bheda rests in me. Atma. But without knowing the other padarthas, you cannot know the Atma. Atma being bhinna from the other padarthas. How do you know the self as being different from the others? Because you know the others. Now, others have to be known, other padarthas. So, itara padartha jnana is needed. This is why they see you analyze everything. Then you will know whether it is you or not. You start analyzing everything. In fact, you look at it, we say drishyatvat mithya. We are looking at everything. We are looking at the drishyatva being there. That's all. They are analyzing anything and everything in the padartha. We don't get lost in that kind of a samsara. इतर पदार्थ ज्ञानम अंतरा आत्मनि इतर पदार्थ भेद ज्ञानम न संभवेत यस्य भेद अन्यत्र भवति सह भेद प्रतियोगी इत्युच्यते. दे टॉक अबाउट प्रतियोगी. यस्य भेदः अन्यत्र भवति, सो दे भेद प्रतियोगी इज डिस्क्राइब्ड. हु इज अ भेद प्रतियोगी और व्हाट इज अ भेद प्रतियोगी? यस्य भेद अन्यत्र भवति. So, bheda from something else that is there elsewhere, that is called as bheda pratyogi. Tadrusha pratyogi jnanam vina bheda jnanam na sambhavati. Now, you have to know the bheda pratyogi also to know bheda also. To know the bheda, you have to know the bheda pratyogi. You have to know them as a pair, a counterpart. So, yasya abhava sa pratyogi. That is the definition of pratyogi. Now, tadrusha pratyogi jnanam vina bheda jnanam na sambhavati tasmad atmani itara padartha bhedanum iti rupa mananam prati upayogitvaditara padartha nirupanam api tattva jnana upayogi iti tesham matam. So, this tattva jnana they have described as what? Atma देहादि सकल पदार्थेभ्यः भिन्नः इति निश्चय एव तत्त्वज्ञानम्. नाउ दिस तत्त्वज्ञानम् हाउ डू यू गेट? विदाउट दी भेद प्रतियोगी यू कैन नॉट नो भेद. देयरफॉर यू हैव टू नो दी भेद प्रतियोगी आल्सो, द अदर आल्सो कंप्लीटली. तस्माद् आत्मनि इतर पदार्थ भेद अनुमिति रूप मननम, दैट आई एम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दी अदर्स. हाउ डू यू नो? यू हैव अनुमान, यू यूज अनुमान, देन दिस अनुमिति takes place in you, that manana takes place, nischaya, that is sattva jnana, it takes place when tasmad atmani itara padartha bhedanumiti rupa mananam prati upayogitvad itara padartha nirupanam api इतर पदार्थ निरूपणस्य उपयोगित्वात्. दिस अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ऑल द अदर पदार्थास इज नेसेसरी because without the pratyogi jnanam you cannot bheda pratyogi jnanam you cannot know bheda, therefore you have to analyze other also. Tattva jnana upayogi iti tesham matam. What is tattva jnana upayogi? What is useful for tattva jnana? Itara padartha nirupanam api. Knowing the other padarthas also is important. Tad etat na sambhavati. The Siddhanti says that is not possible. Why? Shrutasya artasya nischayam prati anukulaha prameyagata sandeha nivartikascha yayuktayaha tasam chintanam eva mananam ityuchyate. What is really mananam? Shrutasya artasya nischayam prati anukulaha prameyagata sandeha nivartikascha yayuktayaha. Those yuktis, those logical steps are useful. That chintana is manana. We say that yes, manana is chintana rupa, that chintana is yukti rupa. So far you are right, tarka rupa, tarka is needed. But what kind of tarka? There has to be shruti adhara for that. Without shravana, you cannot just do manana. That manana is, that is not called as manana. That can be a yogika utpatti. Through the mandhatu, you may have had a yogika utpatti, but in the context, shastrartha, what is manana? Shravana manana nididhyasana. Kasya shravanam? So, shrutasya artasya nishchayam prati anukulaha. It should be dependent on the shruti. Then you look at the prameya gata sandeha. What you have heard during shravana, there the pramana samshaya should go away. Just give me one moment. Throat is a little itchy. Sorry. So pramana gata sandeha should go away by shravana. What is the tatpare of the shruti? The tatpare of the shruti is advaita atma. Now leaving that aside, if you do any chintana and think that is manana, it is not appropriate. Manana is needed to take away the prameya gata sandeha. I, the Atma, am one with Ishvara. There, prameya gata sandeha is resolved by manana. If your shravana itself has led to some other conclusion, then what you are doing is not manana. Because tatpare nishya itself is incorrect. Where Shruti is not a Pramana, you are using that Shruti Vakya and doing Manana on that or derivative of that, or discarding the Shruti Vakya, you are doing some Chintana. That is not really Manana. Bheda Jnanena tu anartha eva bhavati. Shruti is not talking about Bheda. There is no commitment there. Now you are analyzing this Bheda, Bheda Pratiyogi. It is actually nonsense. Why? It may be very useful in the worldly. Our purpose is not the worldly. What is the purpose? The purpose is adhyatma. This shastra which caters to atma, you are getting lost in anything and everything but that. Bheda jnanena tu anartha eva bhavati. You are spending the entire life in bheda jnana. This is the Nayayika's world. Sarvam khalvidam brahma. When it has been said that everything is brahma, so see, we are also going to use tarka. This tarka is not going to be used so often. You may not even see it in Advaita Shastras. But when you are discussing with a tarkika, you have to use his own tools. It may not be really very entertaining or very valid tarka also if you look at the Shruti perspective for Advaita Shastra. But to do khandana, you have to use their own tarkas. And we are going to kind of, you know, describe the Shruti different from the way we interpret it to counter him. Because he has misinterpreted, we show how that misinterpretation is seen by looking at the Shruti, which can have another meaning also. So, Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma. Advaita is being talked about. So, Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma, where is the Bheda, sir? Ityadi Shruti Vakye Abhedeva Sarva Vedanam Tatparyam Siddham, that Pramana Gata Samshaya has not been resolved, or it has been resolved erroneously because you have erroneously concluded that Bheda is the Tatparya of the Shruti. Bheda is not the Tatparya of the Shruti. Had it been, then your Manana, which has nothing to do with Shravana. So the analysis that you are doing, somebody who does not have any background in Shruti, take a modern scientist, that too outside of India, who has nothing to do with the cultural understanding of India also, those who have come up with these scientific theories, discoveries, they have absolutely no idea of what Shruti talks about. They don't know a thing like Shruti. They also do this Bheda analysis. So where is the Tatparya of the Shruti in Bheda? If at all Shruti does talk about Bheda, it is only an Anuvada. Where is Shruti Pramana? Shruti is Pramana in the Anadhigata Vishaya. That which is unknown to you, which cannot be known by you independently. Just like eyes can see. A person says, my ears see, then eyes have no use. No, I can see through my ears also. I can see from my mouth. Why do I need? You don't need eyes. It is as ridiculous an argument as that. This should be very clear. Shruti being Pramana has to be understood exactly the same way. Bhagavan Sureshwara Acharya talks about this in Naishkarmya Siddhi. He says that Shruti is a Pramana for that Vishaya which cannot be known through any other Pramana, including your Anumana. Just like your ears cannot see, and therefore eyes are Pramana, eyes are the only Pramana, the vision. Chakshu, Chakshurindriya, eyes in a sense Indriya. Chakshurindriya is the only Pramana for Rupa. Why? Because there is no other Indriya which can objectify Rupa. Similarly, the Vishaya of the Shruti, where it is a Pramana, is that which you cannot know through any other Pramana. Pratyaksha Anumana Ityadi Pramana are not valid in whichever Vishaya, that alone is the Vishaya of Shruti, where it is Pramana. That is the real Tatparya of the Shruti. So this Bheda where you are spending time, that Bheda can be known, is already known in fact. Not in as much detail as you are inquiring into, but you are just going to details. Bheda at a superficial level, Bheda at a detail level, Bheda all the way though. So knowing Bheda in detail does not change the fact that Bheda was already known. Through which Pramana? Anything but Shruti. We don't care which Pramana. Was it known? Yes. Was it known to anyone else, or can it be known by anyone else, this Bheda, through any means except for Shruti? Those who have no idea of Shruti, do they know? Yes. A child who is born knows the Bheda. is scared of anyone other than the known mother, the known parents, the known sibling. Starts knowing and then starts understanding that these are my own. Mamakara comes in. Ahankara is still there, but mamakara, this is not me. The child also knows. Then someone else comes up. One knows that Bheda, the child knows that this is a foreigner to me. So what Bheda is Shruti teaching this sadhaka, which even a child knows. So if you understand this concept of pramana, then you can never go wrong as to what is the tatpare of the Shruti. And this is the failure of all darshanas except for Advaita Vedanta. You look at any darshana. That is why each and every darshana which is based on Vedas except for Advaita is a failure, because pramana concept itself isn't there. It falls apart. We don't need to go beyond this point at all. We don't need to even look into any other darshana. Only look at it as to what is there. Pramanya Buddhi. Where is their Pramanya Buddhi? It is in Anumana. All of these have their Pramanya Buddhi in Anumana, because Shruti cannot have Tatparya in Bheda, which is already known to you. They say, no, the Tatparya is in describing Ishvara. But Ishvara as what? What do you get by knowing Ishvara? Because Shruti, it talks about know your Atma. So, if you know Ishvara, having said that, know your Atma, if Shruti is describing Ishvara, if you have little buddhi, if you use your faculty, then you know that having talked about revealing Atma, it talks about Ishvara. Even if you don't agree that Ishvara is being said as Atma, you should at least be able to jump the gap, because you are one who thinks that Anumana is a pramana, so much so that you set aside everything else. So don't you see that when Shruti says that I will talk about Atma and start describing Ishvara, it is describing you. That much you should be able to know even from your own Anumana. Otherwise, Shruti will not be a pramana. So this is a fundamental difference between all darshanas and Advaita. Bheda jnane tu anartha eva bhavati. Sarvam khalvidam brahma ityadi shruti vakyaihi abhede eva sarva vedanam tatparyam siddham. Every Veda, every Upanishad is committed to revealing aikya, Advaita. Ditya advai bhayam bhavati mrityos samrityam apnoti yahi anane eva pashyati ityadi bhihi bheda jnanasi nindacha kriyate. So, Bheda Jnana Ninda is being done and you are spending your entire darshana in explaining Bheda. What a waste. A sheer waste of sadhana. Calling it a sadhana is an insult to sadhana, because you are spending entire time in details of Bheda where Shruti says Vidyadvai Bhayam Bhavati. And also says, does the Ninda is saying that what? Yaha iha nana iva pashyati. By saying iva, Shruti is saying there is no nanatvam. You are saying nanatvam is there. Shruti says iva, you say no. Shruti virodha. So where is your respect towards Shravana? Where is your respect towards Shruti? The audacity of calling yourself as Vaidikas, Astikas, just by saying that no, that iva you ignore. Nana. Nanatvam is not right, because Shruti itself shows that Mithyatva is there in Nanatva Darshana by adding Iva. Okay, if you don't care for that, do you see Nana at least? Forget Iva. Do you see Nanatvam? Yes. Then Mrityoho Samrityum Apnoti Yaha Yanani Iva Pashyati. So forget Nana Iva Pashyati. Nana Pashyati only you take. So one who looks at Bheda, Saha Mrityoho Mrityum Apnoti, goes from Mrityu to Mrityu, continues in Samsara, and you are talking about Moksha through Tattvajnana, and what Tattvajnana? Bheda Tattvajnana. Where do you get all this from? स्वकपोल कल्पितः इट हैज एब्सोल्युटली नो बेसिस इन श्रुति तस्माद् भेद ज्ञानस्य साक्षाद् वा तत्वज्ञान द्वारा वा पुरुषार्थ हेतुत्वं नास्ति एव देयर इज नो पुरुषार्थ एट ऑल धर्मार्थ कहो मोक्ष मोक्ष इज अ रियल पुरुषार्थ दिस भेद ज्ञान कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली लीड टू मोक्ष नॉर कैन इट गिव तत्वज्ञान दैट विल लीड टू मोक्ष इट इज नॉट तत्व एट ऑल किंच मनन शब्दात आत्मनः इतर पदार्थेभ्यः भेद प्रतीति रूपः अर्थः न स्वरसतः भवति किंतु मनन पदस्य चिंतनम् इत्यर्थः एव स्वरसिकः अर्थः द मीनिंग ऑफ मनन आल्सो इज इनवैलिड इन योर केस चिंतनम् इति अर्थः इज वैलिड भेद प्रतीति रूपः अर्थः इज इनवैलिड No, I see bheda between myself and ghata. I see bheda between myself and another spouse, sibling, etc. of mine is all bheda pratiti rupa artha. That is not chintana at all. That is not manana at all. Atmana itara padarthebhya bheda pratiti rupa artha. This is what you consider as manana. How can it be manana? Considering yourself as different from itara padartha, I already know that I am not ghata. Okay. You have done manana. That is not a swarasata meaning at all. What is the meaning? If you inquire into the word manana itself, as described by the Shruti, what is it? Chintanam, atma chintanam. You are doing atmani bheda chintanam, not atma chintanam. वाक्यांतरानुसारेण तु मनन शब्दस्य अभेद चिंतने परिवसानं भवति वेयर इज द कल्मिनेशन ऑफ दिस वर्ड अभेद चिंतने यू लुक एट दी महावाक्यास वाक्यांतरानुसारेण तु मनन शब्दस्य अभेद चिंतने परिवसानं भवति इफ यू कीप ऑन इंक्वायरिंग इनटू दी महावाक्य You see, Abheda is the Tatparya there. That is the culmination of the Shruti's entire effort. Kena api prakarana manana shabdasya atmana itarebhya bheda chintana mityartaha na siddhyati. Even if you analyze the word itself, manana, that meaning that you are using is complete. Nonsense it is. I mean, Nayayika explaining the manana shabda is also a hack. अथवा यदि इतर पदार्थ ज्ञानी नैव पुरुषार्थ साधन साधनीभूत सो मोक्ष इज एक्सप्लेनिंग पुरुषार्थ सो मोक्ष पुरुषार्थ साधनीभूत तत्वज्ञानं प्राप्यत इत्युच्यते तर्हि सकल पुरुषाणां तत्वज्ञान प्राप्तिरिति यत्नतः अयत्नतः प्राप्तिः अयत्नतः सिद्ध्येत सो यदि अदरवाइज यू लुक एट नाउ अदर वे टू रिफ्यूट दी नैयायिका इज व्हाट यदि इतर पदार्थ ज्ञानेन एव मोक्ष पुरुषार्थ साधनीभूत तत्वज्ञानं प्राप्यते इति उच्यते हाउ डू यू गेट दिस मोक्ष पुरुषार्थ व्हाट इज द साधन तत्वज्ञान दिस तत्वज्ञान हाउ डू यू गेट बाय इतर पदार्थ ज्ञान भेद यू एनालाइज भेद अक्रॉस ऑल पदार्थस बिटवीन ऑल पदार्थस व्हेन यू आर एनालाइजिंग दैट Then that becomes the sadhana for tattvajnana. That tattvajnana is a sadhana for moksha. Then what will happen? Tarhi sakala purushanam tattvajnana praptihi ayatnataha siddhye. There is no effort needed. As we saw, even a child knows. The child knows that I am different from others. Child knows that I am different from these things. Then Not much effort is needed for moksha because everyone already knows ayatnataha. Laughable or an impossibility also. Why? Because Nayayikas are going to say, no, the child does not know all sorts of Vedas. Even a scientist doesn't know. Multiple PhDs in various research fields, articles published in journals, peer reviewed. Working with many other great scientists, one grows up and learns, and this journey is never ending if you look at it. Because all padarthas have to be known. Even the scientists who claim to know everything in their own field, they don't claim to know everything in other fields. Even the knowledge that they have, they say that all the scientific knowledge which is there across all scientists put together also is a minuscule of the entire universe out there. We don't even know these multiverses. We don't even know our own universe, let alone multiverses. Therefore, athva na kasyapi siddhyet. Nobody can have this jnana. The jnana, bheda jnana, if it is really tattva jnana sadhana, it cannot be attained by anyone. Only Ishvara is sarvajna, really. Everyone else has sarvajna, sarvavit. Why sarvajna and sarvavit? So there we make a bheda as generally someone knows as sarvajna. So generally sarvajna, you can appreciate someone as, you know, it's a praise. But is really anyone sarvajna? Whoever it is, cannot be. Because antakarana is going to limit. All siddhis also put together, they are going to limit. Even people who say, you know, their kula gurus, their gurus are siddhas, still they cannot solve all your problems for whatever reasons. We are not interested in what reason is there. No one can solve every problem. They themselves have their sharirika problems are there. A mukta also has sharira trouble. Even a siddha mukta has who has siddhis, magical powers. Even that person, if you look at the person, there are other problems. They cannot solve anything and everything. Prarabdha gata limitations are there. So what to talk about this? Sarva padartha bheda jnana athvana kasyapi siddhye tathahi hauso yadi itara padarthanam samanya jnanam tattva jnane apekshyate tada sarva purushanam itara padartha visheka samanya jnanasya sattvat itara padartha jnana purvaka itara padartha bheda jnanena sarvesham tattva jnanam bhavitum arhati. Samanya jnana is expected, then everyone has sarva samanya jnana. If everyone has samanya bheda jnana, then ayatnataha moksha siddhyet. So sarvesham tattva jnanam bhavitum arhati, samanya jnana rupa. That tattva jnana everyone has, then that is a sadhana for moksha. Everyone can get moksha easily. No. Asadharana jnana is needed if you make that argument. Then, okay, we'll take that. Yadi sarva padarthanam asadharana dharma puraskarena itara padarthanam jnanam tattva jnane apekshyate tada sarvejnya ishvara sarvajneshwaram vina na kasyapi asadharana dharma puraskarena sakala itara padartha jnanam sambhavet. So if you say no, you need to have asadharana jnana of bheda from sakala padarthas, then sarve sarvajnya, who is sarvajnya? Sakala padartha jnana is there in Ishvara. So sarvajneshwaram vinana kasyapi asadharana dharma puraskarena sakala itara padartha jnanam sambhavet. Na sambhavet. Not possible for anyone, let alone some nayayika. Nobody can get this jnana other than Ishvara. Tasmat sakala itara padartha jnana purvakam atmani itara padartha bheda jnana se abhavat sakala anatma padartha bhinna atma jnana rupa tattva jnanam na kasyapi bhavet. Since you expect asadharana jnana of each and every padartha, you cannot know each and every padartha at all, nobody can know. Therefore, the atma itara padartha bheda jnana not being possible unless you know asadharanataya, you know sakala padarthas, itara padarthas. Since that is not possible, you don't have a basis for Atmani in the Atma having itara padartha bheda jnana. Because bheda pratiyogi, sakala padartha bheda pratiyogi is there in sakala padartha. You have to know each of these sakala padarthas which cannot be known. Therefore, bheda pratiyogi tattva jnanasya abhavat Atmani itara padartha bheda jnanasya abhavaha. Therefore, tasmat sakala anatma padartha bhinna atma jnana rupa tattva jnanam na kasyapi bhavet. It is impossible to know atma being different from each and every padartha because of the lack of knowledge of all padarthas. Impossibility of the knowledge. Not only you do not know now, you can never know. Tasmat nayayika abhimatasya atmanaha swasajatiyani atmabhya vijatiya anatma padarthebhyascha bheda jnanam na sambhavet. So swasajatiyani atmabhya vijatiya. Tasmat nayayika abhimatasya atmanaha. That atma in nayayika mata, if you look into it, then that atma, atmanaha swasajatiyani atmabhya vijatiya anatma padarthebhyascha bheda jnanam. All those are different atmas. Swasajatiya. Atmas are what? Swasajatiya. From those atmas, I am different. How? Because I have this bheda from other atma. How will I know? I have this bheda from other atmas. That is possible only when I know other atmas. I cannot know other atmas. How about other anatmas which are vijatiya from atma? Those anatma padarthas also I cannot know completely. Therefore, I cannot know bheda. Atmana bheda jnanam na sambhavet. Tasmat nayayika matanusarinam tattvajnana sambhavat tattvajnanasya sambhavat. It is not possible. Therefore, dehadishu atma bhrantehe abhavaha na siddhyet. So this atma bhranti unto dehas will never go. Because you will never know all dehas, you will not know all atmas, you will not know all anatmas. Therefore, atma having bheda from this deha also cannot be known. That bhranti will never go. Since that bhranti will not go, moksha will be impossible. Pravritya bhava siddhau sharira sambandha rupa janma bhavaschana siddhyet. So janma bhava is also not possible. Moksha is not possible because sharira sambandha rupa janma will not be going at all. It will continue. Janma bhava siddhau ekavimshati dukkha dhvamsa rupa moksho api na siddhyet. So he is jumping ahead. We'll look at this in the Moola. Jumping ahead in a sense, if we don't know what these ekavimshati dukkha, all these are there. So Nayayikas talk about these ekavimshati dukkhas, the 21 dukkhas. We don't care about all these as to what are these exactly, but Moola will mention these. So this moksha from those kind of dukkhas is moksha. Dhamsa of those dukkhas is moksha. Sadapina siddhyet, that will also not be possible. Kintu mahavakya rupa shrutyartha bhuta bheda jnanam meva karana sahita sakala anartha nivritti purvaka paramananda prapti rupa moksha hetuhu. Then what is the real moksha hetu? When moksha it is not possible, moksha itself isn't possible in nayayika mata, or it is ayatnata siddha. Ayatnata siddha, nobody is going to agree. Struggling for moksha and you say that it is easily achieved, that is not acceptable. Then it is impossible. There is no middle way. So Vedanta has shown that either you say that it is easily attainable, he says no, it is not possible, we are struggling. Then the Siddhanti says you struggle forever, still you will never become Ishwara. You can never become Sarvajna Ishvara. Therefore, you will never get moksha. Kintu Mahavakya Rupa. Then how is it possible? This is the only way out. Nanyav Pantha Vidyate Anaya. Kintu Mahavakya Rupa Shrutyartha Bhuta Abheda Jnanam. So your focus is on Bheda, whereas you should switch it to Abheda. So Abheda Jnanam Eva Karana Sahita Sakala Anartha Nivritti Purvaka Paramananda Prapti Rupa Moksha Hetu. Hetu for Moksha is Abheda Jnana. What kind of Moksha? Ananda Prapti Rupa. Where there is no Dukkha, your Ekavimshati Dukkha, Dhamsa will take place because Anartha Nivritti Purvaka Paramananda Prapti. And what is that? Karana Sahita Sakala Anartha Nivritti Purvaka. So that Nivritti is of Sakala Anarthas. Along with the Karana for the Sakala Anarthas. The Sakala Anartha Karana is Avidya, Ajnana. So Ajnana Nivritti is through Jnana. That Jnana is Abheda Jnana. So this is the only way there can be moksha, otherwise moksha is not possible. So Tippadakara has already shown now here in Mula, Dehadi Sakala Padarthibhya Atma Bhinnaha Iti Nishcheva Tattva Jnanam. We took a detour into Tippada from Bhinna. Tena Tattva Jnanam Aham Manushya Brahmana Iti Bhrantir Nivartate. They say this Bhranti will go away once Tattva Jnanam takes place. Then Bhranti Nashi Ragadvesha Unashyata. Ragadvesha will go away once this Dehadu Atma Bhranti goes away. Ragadveshiyor abhave dharma dharmartha karma karmani pravrtirna bhavati. Then these karmas which lead to dharma and adharma, they won't continue because ragadveshas aren't there anymore. Pravrtya bhave sharira sambandha rupa janma bhava siddhyati. Once pravrtti is not there in karma, dharma dharma are not there, then how will sharira sambandha be there? So this janma will not be there henceforth. Prarabdhantu bhogena nashyati. However, you live out this Janma Prarabdha, Sharira Sambandha Bhave Ekavamshati Dukkhanam Dhamsa Bhavati. Then Sharira Sambandha goes away in future. There is no future Janma, therefore, there is no Jivan Mukti. Videya Mukti, the Sharira Prarabdha Kshaye Sharira Nasha, then Sharira Pata, after Sharira drops away, then you will not get any more Sharira. Then what will happen? These Ekavimshati Dukkha Dhamsa will take place. What are these? Nyayamate Tadrisha Dukkha Dhamsa Eva Mokshaha. Moksha is cessation of, destruction of these Ekavimshati Dukkhas. What are these Ekavimshati Dukkha? Shariram Shrotra Twang Twak Netra Jivha Ghrana Manamsi Iti Shad Indriyani. There are six Indriyas. They consider Mana also as Indriya, which you call as Antakarana. So, Shariram, Shrotra, Twak, Netra, Jivha, Ghrana. These are the five Indriyas. Mana also. Manashashtani Indriyani. So, there is a sixth. Sharira and the six Indriyas. Kshannam Indriyanam Vishayaha. Each of these will have Shrotra, will have Shabda. So, Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. These are the Kshannam Indriyanam Vishayaha. These are the Vishayas of the six Indriyas. Shad Indriya. So those are the five, and then Manaha also has its own Vishaya. That also is included. Shad Indriya Janya Jnanani. Then Indriya Janya Jnana is there. Indriyas are Pramana for Jnana. Sukadukhe Iti. So Sukadukha is also there in the Manas, which they consider as being there in the Atma. Iti Tanmate Ekavimshati Dukkhani. All these jnanas, sukadukhas, where are they taking place? They are taking place in Atma. Atma should be free from this. Then only there is moksha. Shariradikam dukkhat janakatva dukkham iti kathyate. So this ekavimshati dukkha, what are these? Shariradi dukkhat janakatva dukkham iti kathyate. Shariradi dukkham. Sharira. Indriyas, Indriya Vishayas, इंद्रिय जन्य ज्ञान सुख दुख इत्यादि ऑल दीज आर कंसिडर्ड एज दुखास व्हाई दुख जनकत्वा दुखम दे आर कॉल्ड एज दुख बिकॉज दे आर द सोर्स ऑफ दुख यू लुक एट समवन यू से दैट ओ सच अ प्लेजर टू सी यू बट यू नो यू टॉक अबाउट दैट पर्सन एज प्लेजर ओ eating something oh sukha ananda so you consider that itself as sukha similarly dukha this person is a pain that person is not pain that person causes pain but you say that person is a pain most common you know this person is a pain in my neck so that person is not the pain dukha karana this is where our thinking is और थिंकिंग इज दिस पर्सन इज दुख कारण बट दुख तस्मा दुखम इत्युच्यते यद्यपि न्यायमते श्रोत्र मनसोः नित्यत्वात् तयोर् नाशः न संभवति तथापि येन रूपेण श्रोत्र मनसोः दुख हेतुत्वं तद्रूपं नश्यति सो वी विल सी दिस इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट देयर इज अ टिप्पण आल्सो वी हैव टू लुक एट एज टू दिस जस्ट अ बेसिक ओवरव्यू ऑफ दिस व्हाई आर द श्रोत्र मनस कॉल्ड एज नित्य वी विल हैव अ short detour and close on nayayikamata sukam nityam suprakasham vyapakam namrupa adhisthanam buddhye bodhyam buddher drukyatni nirguna uparam sravedanta vidyam pratyak param mahat devannamattu nityam namaste any questions anyway you may not be interested in these details in the their darshana what all they talk about but this helps looking at the modern perspective of the scientist also as to how you analyze everything and spend the time there but miss out the atma who, which is a constant across all this anuvritti of atma is missed unfortunately anatma is the focus ni namaste om tat sat
namaste
hari om